Drexel University's Dornsife School of Public Health announced plans to launch a research center on racism and health. A $9 million gift from philanthropist and alumna Dana Dornsife and her husband David will help to further research on racial inequity and disparities in health.
Drexel University College of Medicine is celebrating the opening of a new four-year regional campus in Berks County. A ribbon cutting was held to mark the opening of the new facility yesterday in Wyomissing. It's made possible thanks to a collaboration with Tower Health. The college will welcome its inaugural class of 40 first-year medical students come next Monday.
For the first time in the history of Drexel University, both the men's and women's basketball teams are heading to the NCAA tournament. As NBC 10's Stephen Fisher shows us, the campus is beaming with pride.
Okay, so Lyric, we have gathered your family here, the Drexel cheerleaders and mascot. I'm sure, as you can imagine, we know you're going to Drexel right up the street. I'm sure, as you can imagine, you're not just a finalist for this scholarship, and you didn't win the $10,000 scholarship. Our friends at Tallow, a mobile platform that connects students with opportunities, is gifting you with a $50,000 scholarship towards your future.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much.
The Phillies will open their season tomorrow in front of more than 8,000 fans, and that's all thanks to an intern.
Can you imagine? It's an intern who did all this. The senior at Drexel created the document the team is using to bring people back.
Maria Swabilius didn't have a regular internship experience, but nevertheless, she found a way to hit it out of the park while interning for the Phillies, figuring out how to bring everyone back safely.
Maria is a superstar for the Phillies.
Josh Barbieri runs business analytics for the Phillies, and he says through their partnership with Drexel, they pitched Maria work on the project that would create the map for bringing Phillies fans back to the park.
EGS, or Entrepreneur Game Studio, was started in 2013, and I want to educate people to help them develop an entrepreneurial mindset.
The Philadelphia landscape has continued to evolve and transform. The Lindy Institute for Urban Innovation at Drexel University strives to create new opportunities for an equitable and inclusive Philadelphia.
Civic engagement is really a cornerstone of good urban design. Projects that affect the public broadly demand a robust public engagement. John Fry, who's the president of Drexel University, said, "I want the Lindy Institute to be a bully pulpit on urbanism for the university locally, nationally, and globally."
Dr. Loretta Jamont, the vice president of Drexel University Health Equity, created Community Impact. The pilot program helps cancer patients receive resources and treatment. It's based in West Philadelphia, a community too long overlooked and underserved.
And so we want to get people connected to programs, get people connected to screening, get people connected to treatment and to clinical trials, because we want to make sure that we save lives, and we're here to beat it and to treat it.
Pennsylvania's First Lady got together with a group of experts to talk about ways that art can help people heal from some of the damage that the pandemic is causing.
What the arts do is give us moments of joy, give us moments of playfulness and connection that otherwise are denied, and a challenge for those who've been through intense trauma and adversity.
Drexel University law professor Wendy Green has worked with legislators around the country to create the Crown Act. It's a law that bans discrimination in workplaces and in schools against hair textures or styles linked to racial identity.
It really clarifies that natural hair discrimination in all forms constitutes race discrimination. Our hair has nothing to do with our competencies and our qualifications and our abilities, and therefore shouldn't have anything to do with whether or not we're afforded employment opportunities or we should be included in certain spaces.
Let's turn to Dr. Michael Levasseur now, epidemiologist, assistant professor at Drexel University. It was his research that alerted the CDC to that Provincetown cluster and the dangers of the Delta variant. Doctor, thanks so much. You've been studying and modeling COVID cases for a year now. Why did this particular finding convince you that you had to reach out?
Well, it was a couple of things, and it's not just me working on this. I have a collaborator that I've been working with very closely named Michael Donnelly. And what we saw was there were a lot of people that we knew through social media who had attended these events during those weekends, and it was just a large cluster of individuals, specifically people who were staying in the same vacation home. It was really sort of that information that set us to start asking questions and trying to gather as much information as possible.
I want to bring in now Abeyua Agayari, a professor of structural engineering at Drexel University. Does this offer clues as to why this building came down?
The clue it offers is that the engineer should have been given access to check the interior of the building, the slab to column connections.
For more on that, we're joined by Robert Field, a professor of law and public health at Drexel University in Philadelphia. Professor Field, welcome to the program.
Thanks. Happy to be here.
Explain the settlement to us. How does it work?
So the biggest part of the settlement is a lot of money. $8.3 billion sounds like a lot to most of us. Most of that goes towards criminal and civil penalties for the company admitting that it broke the law and committed some pretty serious crimes.
I'm pretty sure we're all going to be working for our next guest. A Drexel University student lands her dream internship. She's one of 50 kids chosen for the prestigious Television Academy internship program. And with the Emmys coming up next month, it's the perfect time for the emerging producer to get her feet wet. Carly Genyon joins us now.
Thanks for having me, Bill. It's great to be here.
I appreciate you. All right, so congratulations first. And how does it feel to be just one of 50? That's pretty prestigious.
It truly was a surprise.
Philadelphia is bugging out. Bugfest is back at the Academy of Natural Sciences after it had to be canceled last year because of COVID. Adults and kids can check out live bug displays and shows. Cicada specimens, the Roach Race 500. That's going to be fun.
Two organizations in our area teamed up today to help children get ready for the fast approaching school year. Eyewitness News at St. Christopher's Hospital today, and that's where there was a free drive-up distribution of backpacks full of school supplies. The event was a joint effort by St. Christopher's and Drexel University.
Tonight, Drexel University celebrated the launch of its new Center for Black Culture with a virtual event. This all to welcome black students, faculty, staff, and alumni.
This was commencement night for the class of 2021 at Drexel University. Wearing blue robes, the graduates filed into Citizens Bank Park. The seniors waved to the camera and to their loved ones in attendance.